In this section, we will learn about do while. In the last section, we were discussing about while loop. So let's go through that first. In while loop, the condition is tested before the loop is executed. So because of that, it is called entry controlled loop. So at first, the condition is verified, and only if it is true, the body of the loop is executed. So if the condition is not satisfied, it won't be executed at all. So that is the difference of while loop. It's an entry control loop. But in some conditions, it's not possible to go with while loop. It is necessary to execute the body at least one time. Okay. So in such cases, we need an exit control loop. That is because at least one time we need to execute the loop, and then only we need to check the condition. So in that case, we need an exit controlled loop. And do while is an example for exit controlled loop. So the last section we explained with an example while loop, and that is an entry controlled loop because condition was verified first. And if the condition is true, what will happen? It will go to body of the loop and it will be executed. Again, what will happen after executing it one time? It will go to the beginning of the loop and again will check the condition. If it is false, it will come out of the loop. But in case of do while, the condition is verified only at the end of the loop. So minimum one time it will be executed. The loop will be executed. So difference is while is an entry controlled loop, while do while is an exit controlled loop. So syntax while we already learned. This was the syntax of while loop. But in do while, you know that here while test condition was given before the loop. Here it is given after the loop. And one more thing you should remember here, it should be terminated with a semicolon. While writing this, there was no semicolon after the condition. Okay, and always the body of the loop is enclosed in curly brackets or braces. So this is a syntax for do while. Do and while both are keywords. This is the flow chart for do while. The loop starts and it will directly execute the body of the loop, and only after executing it, it will check the condition. If the condition is true, it will go back to the loop. If it is false, the loop will end. So this is an exit controlled loop. On reaching the do statement, the program proceeds to the loop. At the end of the loop, test condition is evaluated. If condition is true, program continues to evaluate the body. The process continues as long as the condition is true. So to come out of the loop, the only option is the condition should become false. That is almost same for both while and do while. Difference is in where we are placing the condition. One is at the entry and the other is at the exit. When condition becomes false, loop will be terminated and control goes to the statement that appears immediately after the while statement. As test condition is evaluated at the bottom of the loop, do while is an exit control loop and body is always executed at least once. So now let's check a program, a simple program with the do while. So in the last section, we discussed this program, that is to print first n natural numbers using while loop. This is an entry controlled loop. Okay, so in while, we gave the condition along with while. So entry controlled loop, and before entering the loop, the condition is verified. If the condition is true, the loop will be executed. And within the loop, there is a provision for incrementing the value of I. And when it comes out of the loop, again, the condition will be verified. So it is an entry controlled loop. So here we are going to write a program using do while. So let's modify this program. So our requirement is to write a program to print first n natural numbers. So similarly, just like using while, we get the value of n from the user, and after that there is difference in the syntax. It is do while, so we modify it do, and in syntax of do there is no condition. Okay, so it is just do. Do is a keyword. Do, then curly brackets, and you can give the loop. So our requirement is to print the value of I. I is varying from 1 to n. So I plus plus value, the loop variable should be updated within the loop. And here you give the condition. Do while you give the condition, say I less than or equal to n. And here you should remember there is a semicolon in the syntax. So this is a do while loop. We just modified the code using do while, and after that you terminate it with a semicolon. And you know that do while is an example for exit controlled loop. So only after entering the loop, what will happen? After entering the loop, then only the condition is verified. So that's why we call it as an exit controlled loop. Okay, so condition is not verified at the beginning. So minimum one time this loop will be executed. That was explained earlier. Okay, so minimum one time this will be executed because it is not an entry control loop. And because of that, condition is not verified before entering the loop. So minimum one time it is executed. So if I value is 1, it is executed and 1 is printed. Then I value becomes 2. From 1 it is incremented at. So it becomes 2. Then it will check the condition while I less than or equal. So 2, if I give the value of n as 10, then it will check 2 less than or equal to 10. So what will happen? It's true. So it will again go back. Okay, so that is the difference. There is difference in executing it. Still output will remain the same. In some programs, we specifically need exit control loop because minimum one time we need to execute the loop. So in that cases, it makes a difference. But in these programs, there won't be any difference. You can either use while or do while. So let's compile it and run. Just like the last case, we need the value of n. Say let's give it as 10 and you got the output. Okay, so in case of while, it was entry control. So for the first loop, it becomes 1. I has value 1 and it is verified, it is executed. Then only it is verified. While I less than or equal to n. So that was the condition. So first condition was verified. But in this case, for corresponding value of I as 1, loop is automatically executed. No condition is verified, or only after executing that loop, it is verified. So that is the only difference. Difference in while and do while is it about the condition verification. One is at the entry and the other is at the exit. So this is a simple example with do while loop.